We started filming already.
I don't know what's going on.
Learning. You just want to put it
up. Oh,
there.
It is recording. That's so special. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to Viking Ventures, and this is episode Trez of the ZX9 project.
What's Trez?
Three. It's three? Yeah. So weak. Right, so while Mikey is going to be putting on this new double bubble screen that we've got, I just want to just take you around the bike and to show you what we have actually done and what we haven't done, or is still yet to be done. Making a mess.
Chucking stuff about.
I think in the last video we left it where we hadn't actually put the chain sprockets on. Well, you can clearly see the chain sprockets is on now. Nice new titanium nuts as well, all clean and tidy. Hugger is back on. We've got the Insta360 mounted to the bike. The cooling system's been fixed. Repaired the hose. Comes down past the gearbox sprocket.
Did you flush it out then and put new coolant in?
Yeah. What else have we done? Another thing as well is we need to give a shout out to Glover's Motorcycles, Kevin Glover. We had some issues with our calipers, and it was actually cheaper and more cost effective to have them done by somebody else. So he's done an absolutely sterling job.
Brilliant, don't they?
They look nice. Absolutely amazing.
Totally work, eh?
Yeah, they should have. That's kind of like the most important thing. So we've got custom lines on there, we've got new sintered pads which have gone in, and some completely reconditioned calipers which should give us hopefully a better feeling brake setup, because the brakes on this bike were atrocious.
And you've done the
we've got the RC19 quarter courser on there as well, so that should make braking feel a lot better. They feel all right.
Are you going to tell everybody the catastrophe that came with the chain or not? Or just
we're going to have to tell them about it, because we had me and Mike hanging off this bike trying to get that gearbox sprocket undone, and it just was not happening. So brought a new impact gun, 2 second job, straight off. It was easy. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. We've also got some new axle sliders. We got a bit of crash protection. Not trying to tempt fate or anything. It would be rude not to, really, wouldn't it? After spending so much money on a track weapon. This is kind of just us just finishing off the bike in preparation for the day after tomorrow, which is Wednesday. Is it the 14th or the 15th?
14th, isn't it?
14th of August. Where we will be taking it to Oulton Park and having our first track experience. So, I love it. Do you know what? I saved
you
that just, little you, bit of wrapping
you
just so
like
you could
that,
just peel
you?
It off at the end. It's nice. That's going to look so much better on the inside, mate. So,
let's just try to get the bottom bit in.
There we go. And then just slide
without
it in.
Popping out.
Slide into it like a vicar into a choir boy.
You'll edit that bit out, won't you?
I might do, you never know.
Right, I'll get this top. Hang on, one socket in me.
Righty McTighty. Yeah, looks much better that. Loads better. Yeah, we did actually get some mirror blanks as well. But it turns out that these just do not fit. The holes do not line up at all. They will not go in, which is a bit annoying, but it is what it is. You've got a RAV as well. Is this brake lever guard? This is a must. You have to have that, because it won't let you on track.
What else was there as well?
Protector.
back protector.
Yeah. I mean, I ordered one, but I haven't got, I don't think that's the right one. I think you've got to have like a proper, like hard thing.
We'll sort it out.
It's going to be so much fun. It's going to be brilliant. I can't honestly wait for it. It's going to be great. Tyres are good. Yeah, cooling system, brakes have all been sorted out. Right, it's been a little bit of a, been a long time coming, hasn't it, this third video, to
be honest? Yeah, well, we were going to go in July, weren't we? And then I can't remember, why didn't we end up going in July?
It's just work, though, wasn't it?
Yeah.
You know, just making sure, that because obviously we both work full time. Well, one of us works full time. The other one just kind of just leisurely plays, hasn't it? Oh, I'm sorry, Big Mike.
I'm a highly skilled professional.
He's a highly skilled professional. That's it. But yeah, looking good, mate. Looking good. Nice 520 chain conversion kit on there as well. Just trying to think if there's anything else that we've forgotten about, to be honest.
We're going
to
put the baffling out with for the exhaust.
Oh, I've already done it.
Have you?
Baffle's already in. Okay. Yeah. I didn't really want to forget about that, to be honest. It's one of these.
Oh, it's that one that dropped on the floor.
There you go, mate. Put that on there. There we go, see. Nice new shiny screen. That looks so much better. So much better. Shame it hasn't got like a rubber thing that goes on the top of there. But it is what it is.
So where are you thinking of putting the cameras?
I think the GoPro is going to have to either go.
So what, you've got a bracket on the back, on the rear foot thing, haven't you?
Yeah, so we've got the Insta 360 is going to go here. I've got a sticky pad which is going to take the other GoPro, which is going to look this way. And then we've got another one which is going to be on the front, which I think I've ordered a special bracket which mounts this cross member. And then that should give us the height that we need to see over and down. Because otherwise, if we stick it there, you're just going to be, it's always going to film as your boobs. And nobody wants to see that. Mikey hard at work. That's it, mate. Keep plenty of pressure on that.
The one's alright, that one down there wants to do it, redoing.
Bottom one's that good. One this one here, yeah. That top one as well needs to be done, I think. Yeah, that needs doing. But yeah, she's looking good. Really, really impressed with them calipers.
What tire pressures are we going to run, do you know?
I don't know, run what, 34, 30 or something? That'd be alright, wouldn't it?
I don't know.
I reckon.
It should be a nice day as well, though, shouldn't it?
It should be a nice day. But yeah, going back to these calipers, if you were...
Chuffed what? With them, aren't you, them calipers?
Mate, honestly, I was
we were so dreading them, weren't we?
With these. He'd done such a good job that I couldn't have done them myself, like, for cheaper than that. I just couldn't.
It's crazy, isn't it?
It's freed me up the time to work on other things. So if you have any calipers or anything like that you want refreshing, give Glover's Motorcycles a ring. Give us an absolutely brilliant price. Did an absolutely cracking job of it as well. So yeah, thanks very much for doing them for us, Kev. Much appreciated. Just trying to think what else there is to do now.
Have you adjusted that the gear lever?
Gear lever, we're going to have to adjust while we're riding it.
You reckon?
Yeah. Because I've set it to where I think it might be all right, but then where you think and where it is going to be all right, there's a fine line between. So it's just a 10mm spanner, we can slack that off, pull that off, and then just readjust that. But if we take it round the yard or take it round the village, just as a quick test run, we should be all right. But yeah, nice new shiny screen on there. I see why they have that black, you know, that black panel on the old screen that goes across here, hides all this gubbins.
Hides all that gubbins, doesn't it? My blade's got the same.
Yeah. But what we need it for, it doesn't really matter.
Can we just highlight this here? This is a special part.
Yeah, that's special. Yeah, but that's from where the last owner dropped it. But other than that, I think we're frigging good to go, mate. Get these fairings put back on. Get the crash bungs back on as well. We should be frigging laughing.
So we've had oil filters, air filter, oil filter, fuel filter.
Yeah.
We've dropped the fluids.
Yeah, all of them.
It's all good to go, isn't it?
Yeah, it is absolutely good to go.
You love your shiny gold chain.
We do love shiny gold chains.
Well, you do, because you like a bit of bling, don't you?
Well, yeah, everyone needs a little bling in their life, mate.
So have you got the bolts for this
bit in fairing? That bag of bolts that you've
right, I've just put on the table.
Ah, yeah, that's it. They're all the new fairing bolts that we've got for it. So there's new clips in there as well.
There's a big one goes in, goes through here then. Yeah.
Yeah, there'll be one or two larger ones, I imagine, in here. Well, there must be, because it's a full fairing bolt kit. But I don't think it's given us them large ones, you know.
Yeah, it's going to want a bit of bedding in first.
I know what you're saying.
I'll give it a thrash.
Give it a thrash. Give it a thrashing. Right, but first, we need to get this on here. Which is, listen, that's got all, oh bloody hell, the rubber bushings and these are all knackered. I see now why they've given us so many. They're all squeezed up. All squeezed up. So in you go, you bastard.
There's some big ones here, Chris, in this other bag. These fit.
Ah, that must be for that. Yeah, yeah, that's got to be for the main bolt. For the main bolts, yeah. That sits so unsnugly on that. That's weird. Right, well, I think I'll get this in and get a bolt in that.
Have you got one in?
Yeah. Just one of these little ones for now. That'll just hold it too. And we've got a couple of Lowlands to go in there.
Check you out, old Cumbrian.
Lowlands.
Is that big one going there?
Yeah, that'll go in there, aye. Definitely. Definitely.
That bloody surgical team of motorcyclists.
I know what you're saying, mate, I do. Right, we won't do that up tight yet until we've got the rest on, because this thing here, this is all broken, this bit, isn't it?
Where's characterful.
Yeah, yeah.
Where's the other bit? Where's the other bit off it?
What the hell's that?
I don't know, it's probably rod doing some cutting.
Right, so what we're going to do is we're going to quickly fire all these fairings back on, get them all buttoned up and finished off, and then we'll bring you back once we're finished. And you can see what she's like. Which is obviously covered in war wounds, I mean, but it's a 20-odd-year-old bike.
Why not?
But yeah, I'm absolutely foaming at the gash, mate, to get there on Wednesday, to be honest. It's going to be so frigging good.
You're going to edit this, aren't you?
I might do. Right, well, the master mechanic has done one side.
Oh, I should have brought my mic and the mechanic's T-shirt.
yeah. So... So now we're just going to be attaching the left-hand side of the fairing. You have to excuse the noise. We're having some work done on the new unit. I will get a nut and bolt to do that upper side.
Because we're going to need some it.
But yeah, I think we're going to be in for a bit of luck, mate, because I think the weather's supposed to be absolutely amazing, isn't it?
So it's roasting down south today.
Hasn't been roasting up here. Nasty. Nasty.
That'll do. That'll be bloody fine. Bloody stunning.
You alright there?
Yeah, I think.
Is it a mirror image of what we've got this side then?
Pretty much, mate, yeah. Although I think you've got a tab on that side, so this fairing, this side of fairing, yours will fit on nicely. But I just think if we can need to get that under section round. And then we need to lift it up and then into position.
Well done, Doris.
You okay there?
Yeah, I think I'm about right.
Sweet.
Right, there isn't going to be much holding this on.
OK, Okay, that's not a big one, that's a small one. Do 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 do.
Think anybody will notice I've had my hair cut?
Possibly.
I thought if we're doing like doing this next bit of video, I thought I should have had my hair cut in. But you don't want to be on the video with a fresh haircut, do you? You want it to grow out a couple of days.
Yeah. So it doesn't look as if you've had your hair cut especially for the video. Yes, you'll have to let us know if any of you guys have been round at Oulton Park. What you liked and disliked about it.
Yeah. Any tips? And if you can tell us before Wednesday, that'd be good, even though this will probably come out next Saturday.
Yeah. Could have been and gone. You should have done this.
Hopefully
you should have done that.
Grass tracking again, eh?
Well, the HP4 wanted to see the grass. It's never seen grass before. Yeah, fairings have definitely seen bloody better days, like.
Perfect, that. Ideal.
Without a doubt. I know what you're saying. We've got brand new bolts to stick in there, though, don't forget.
I put a brand new one in there.
Yeah.
These are all new. What else have you got?
Let's take that one out.
Oh, that one out. There's that one there.
Yeah. I'll get one more in there.
Yeah, it's not really something I ever thought I'd see myself doing, to be honest.
What's that? Track day?
Track days and that.
Well, we were talking about it for a while, that's the thing, weren't we?
The thing is that you can't really go out on the road and have proper fun, can you?
I don't know.
Well, I mean, we had a good laugh on Sunday, but yeah, it's just, it's a safer environment, so to speak.
Yeah. Everybody's going in the same direction. Everyone's no traffic lights.
Yeah, that's it.
You haven't got any farmer's gates to go heading into
traffic lights mid-corner. Yeah, that was scary, that. I will say. Just for a little bit of context, me and Mike went out for a squeeze on Sunday. Proper nice weather.
It's a beautiful day, wasn't it? Best
it
day
was
of the year.
It was proper nice, yeah. And basically, there was a...
God, I'm going to love this explanation that you put towards it.
The truth. There is only one version of the truth, Big Mike.
I'm trying to think of what that saying that Casey Stoner said to Valentino Rossi.
Yeah.
It'll come to me.
I'm sure it will. But basically...
Your ambition outweighed your talent.
That's it.
That's what it was, wasn't it?
No, but the thing is, though, is that they were nasty because... Right, I'd go around this long right-hand bend and about two-thirds of the way around this corner... I don't know why I'm looking at him for, it's just to put me off. They put traffic lights, but there was no sign. I didn't see a sign. You didn't see a sign. No one's seen a sign. And it was either going to oncoming traffic or into a farmer's field. So the poor HP4.
So I was monitoring you because I was just seeing how you were riding.
Yeah,
and
that's it,
your
mate.
Ability.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
From a safe distance.
Yeah, from a safe distance. I
and then there was this
myself.
Corner and then Chris decided not to go around it
just park it
against the farmer's field. Yeah. And then we thought it best just to have a 5-minute debrief and chill out.
Yeah, I needed that debrief right there and then, to be honest. Definitely needed that. Definitely. That was a much needed break. But what happened to you, Mike? I wasn't the only one who had a close call on Sunday.
No, my mum might watch this.
As if she won't watch it. This mic and that stupid.
Well, it's just one of those out of body near miss experiences.
I know what you're saying, mate. Yeah, but now your mum's going to think I'm the bellend.
Fair comment.
That's just so nasty. So nasty. Right, so
I tell you,
we've got one missing.
We'll have to take some, remember to take a jerry can with some fuel.
Yeah, because we're not going to want to keep a full tank of fuel in it constantly.
Well, we don't know how much we're going to use. Six sessions maybe, I don't know.
Yeah, we're probably better off. I'll take one of them big black tubs full of E5, and then what we'll do is...
Some bananas.
Yeah.
Flapjack.
Yeah, flapjack, yeah. Can eat flapjack.
I wonder if it'll be like a burger wagon or something.
We can only hope, mate. We can only friggin'
hope. I'm well looking forward to it now.
I know what you're saying.
It's going to be a culinary experience.
A culinary experience. Right, well, there's one missing there. That clips in now.
Right, so you've got one to put in.
What do you want? Another one?
It's going to be a small one. I need one which I don't think is a shouldered bolt to go through here.
That's if it does actually fit. Your bloody bolt's not long enough.
So you think these brakes are... You think the brakes are bled up all right now?
Kind of hope so. It took fucking ages.
Right. Sure. What goes on there? Is it like a retaining or something?
That looks like that's got an internal feed. Someone's actually drove that in there. I think they're supposed to be...
Is that supposed to come
a
out?
A rubber bush... And then a bolt, a nut or something will go on it. That's supposed to be a nut there. But I think we want to take that out anyway because our crash bung's got to go in there.
All right. Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah, because that's got exactly the same thread. So we're going to want that. And then we can run that straight through there. And that'll give us a little bit of crash protection. She's teat. She's bloody tight, mate. Right, well.
What size is that?
That is a number 5. That's if that'll even go in. Let me just see if I can thread this first, mate, because it won't be the first time they've sent us the wrong bloody bits. Nope, that'll go in there. Sooned. Well, that ain't open. Number 5 end.
Is that it?
Hey. There you go, mate. That will fly in there, that. Looking bloody beautiful. Yeah. Is that even going to...
You know what, it's not going to do
it. It's not
going to
do now, that.
There's no spaces for it as well,
there's
is
no
there?
Spaces. No, it's just an end cap, that's it. Well, they're saying that, I think one is longer than the other. I think. Let me just stick this one on this side and see if this is the same. But then, that's got to go in there. Yeah, no, they're both exactly the same. Yeah, so we'll pull that one out. That's a number 4 that's in there. The Allen key. Which is that one there, mate?
Thanks, mate.
I need to get a bolt which is going to fit in this. In this hole here. Oops.
How did you like the 1299 yesterday?
How did I like
you
it?
You loved it, didn't you?
I absolutely loved it. It was a sterling experience.
Don't tell anybody that I rode the BMW, though, will you?
I won't tell anybody that you absolutely loved my BMW yesterday. I won't tell nobody.
What, that it doesn't handle, but it's got power?
It used to handle really well.
It's all right, apart from the bits where you've got to go around corners.
You really need, to be fair. Right, sorry about that, folks. Battery died, as usual. Frigging GoPros. So what have we done then, Mike?
Are they proper GoPro batteries, then?
They are proper GoPro batteries, yeah. But they're just crap. They just don't really seem to last 2 minutes. I've only got 1 out of 5 batteries that actually doesn't seem to want to cook the camera. As you can see, Mike's put the fairings on. He's done a sterling job of it, I have to say. Screen's gone on.
What else have we got to do?
That's pretty much it.
We're taping up the front headlight or not?
Nah.
No?
Nah, just leave the lights.
We'll tape with us anyway.
Yeah.
Gaffer tape. Put it all back together when you...
Well, just in case when you crash, I can gaffer tape your leg back on and you'll be good as gold. Good as gold.
It's that...
Just go home covered in gaffer tape.
It's that age-old thing, innit? We'll just go for a plod out. We'll just get a feel for it and we'll see if we can get a little bit faster next time and stuff like that. And then...
It's not going to end up like that. It
just 30 isn't. Seconds later.
Yeah. I am going to try and stay extremely disciplined.
Yeah, me too.
And try and get the first session as in that is like, I just want to learn as much as possible. That makes sense.
Oh, we've got a couple of I've got some online things to fill in, like.
What is it? Is it
next
like,
to Kane and stuff like that?
Next to Kane. Where to friggin' send your body parts to when you disembowel yourself.
No, it's all good, eh?
No, I'm happy, mate. I'm happy.
We got a fresh battery in this now, then. Good.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a bit playing that lever, Chris.
It's probably going to need bleeding up tomorrow morning, mate, I reckon. I'm going to leave it tied up overnight.
I mean, it's the wrong shade of red, but I could probably get away with it.
I know what you're saying, mate. I do. I mean, the ultimate would be to have a Ducati track bike, though, wouldn't it? That would
it's
be
a bit alien,
ultimate.
Really, because look at the tank. It's so bloody wide, isn't it?
We said this in the last video. It's going to feel like these
are quite narrow, aren't they?
They are quite narrow. But the thing is, it's still going to feel like a Hayabusa compared to that, yeah. I reckon. And I really don't like Hayabusa.
Like we were saying yesterday, between your HP4 and my 1299, yeah. Like narrow tank, like bloody yeah, scalpels,
yeah.
Aren't they?
It is going to be a completely different experience because this is...
And these bars, you know, we were saying yesterday about how the 1299 differed from the BMW.
From the
it just feels a
yeah,
bit more
yeah,
like that.
Yeah.
That's going to be the same with this.
Yeah. What's for what?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm bleeding.
So, anyway, I've taped up the mirrors because...
Yeah. Okay,
as,
no, that's cool.
As you pass everyone.
Well, that's it, yeah.
I don't want to distract you.
I don't know if that's going to happen. Right, so.
So, back brake lights disconnected.
Yeah, done that. Crash bars, new screen, new master cylinder.
Chain sprockets, it's all good.
Chain sprockets, exhaust has got the baffle in.
You know, the only thing that looks is just these fairing.
It's just
panels.
The fairing just ruins it. Because other than that, this is in properly good nick. Yeah, it really is.
We're just going to see how we go with the forks, aren't we?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, everyone's saying that it's quite a bumpy circuit anyway, so I wouldn't really...
Well, if we take some tools and bits of pieces, we can have a tinker.
Yeah. I mean, we've got like preload adjustment that we can do on here, you know, so we could firm it up a little bit should we need it. But I think the biggest...
So basically what you're saying is our track bike is a knackered road bike, suspension-wise.
I think for road use, suspension felt fine.
All right.
It's not as firm as the 1299, obviously not. It's not as, not quite as, still not even as firm as bloody as the HP4 either, to be honest. But the thing is this is our first track weapon. I think we've done a pretty good job of it, to be honest.
I have.
You've done 90% of the work.
Well,
mate,
I tightened those.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, yeah.
That'll go.
Yeah, that'll just pong. The first thing that
take your cameras
off.
Out in the process.
Yeah. Oh, dear. Baffles in, indicators taped. You mean you don't have to do all of this stuff? You don't have to tape these up. You don't have to do any of it. You can literally just turn up on your bike. It doesn't matter what you've got, and just crack on and enjoy yourself. But that's what this experience is all about, is just going to a safer environment where we can enjoy
everybody's
ourselves.
Everybody's going the same direction with no potholes.
Yeah.
That'll be good fun, be good crack.
No, it's going to be really, really good fun. So, the next time you will see us
We're going to do something from the track.
We're going to be, from the track.
All right, you're going to take the camera. Oh, yeah, we're putting the cameras
on. So I'm just waiting for my new mount to come for this cross brace, and then we can get a camera on the front, we've got a camera on the back, got Insta on the side. It should be really, really good. So you're going to see us explode into a massive ball of fire, tumbling down the track. It could be a successful day out, but
that'd be good crack.
Yeah, it's going to be brilliant. It's going to be brilliant. But please do not forget to like and subscribe, because that helps this channel to grow. You're not bothered. Yeah. I mean, I'm not particularly bothered, but it would be nice to, a little bit of appreciation goes a long way. Obviously, all of this, we pay for all these things out of our own pocket. Nobody sponsors us. Nobody gives us anything for free. I wish they would. If anybody wants to sponsor us, eBay, give us a shout. But, that'll be it from us.
I'm trying to think that way we can have a sponsors.
eBay would be awesome.
Well, they sponsor somebody already, don't they?
Yeah, they do, yeah, but they can sponsor lots of people. That's my helmet. Right. Peace out.
See you later.
See you later.
In A.
In A&E.